This was observed during the committee's visit to the hospital today to find out how the facility operates and how the funds it's given from government are put to use.
There are 333 health facilities, including 8 general hospitals, 13 health center posts, 110 health center threes, and 204 health center twos. By government policy now, most of these health center twos are supposed to be upgraded to health center threes to improve service delivery.
However, the committee was shocked to discover that the regional referral hospital, which covers the districts of Kabarore, Ntoroko, Kamwenge, Fort Portal, Bunyangabu, Kasese, Chenjojo, Chegegwa, Bundibujo, and Chitagwenda, only has 4 beds in its intensive care unit. On discovery, the committee chairperson, Lubega Segona, did not hide his resentment.
A patient who has a contagious disease, I'm sure he would be able to infect virtually all the 3 patients, the other 3 patients. Secondly, in a regional referral hospital, how can you have only 4 beds? Because they have 10 beds which were given to them, but the space can only accommodate 4.
The hospital administrators also informed the members of the committee that the hospital received 10 intensive care unit beds, but were only able to install 4.
I want to find out whether in your strategic plan you are telling government to pique interest that there is an expanded need for these facilities.
The huge numbers of patients received in the facility have also been seen as a threat to the smooth running of the facility. By the end of the third quarter in the financial year 2021-2022, the regional referral hospital had already worked on 14,953 patients out of the annual target the facility had of 20,000 patients.
They actually advised us that expanding ICU comes with other closer sums because they need more staff, they will need more space. So I think a lot has to be done. We are very much understaffed because if the staffing levels are 45%, 44%, and the 56 vacant, we're going to make recommendations to Parliament.
The hospital director informed the committee that the facility needs more health workers so as to work smoothly.
We also experienced delays in receiving our surplus deliveries from NMS. I think they gave an explanation also in writing that they had many and many issues to attend, including providing supplies for vaccines for COVID. So there were these delays in implementing the circles as planned.
The hospital director was, however, tasked to explain why he extended the period of the contractor who is constructing the hospital perimeter wall by 6 months.
In most cases, when patients come, they run out of stock. The hospital runs out of stock, and you find that the medicines that are supposed to run for 2 months, they end up running for only 1 month. So this is something that we have been advocating for. And this financial year, at least they've increased the budget for the hospital from 8.5 billion to 11.
The committee also learned that out of the 720 million shillings given to the facility for construction of the same, the facility had only used 154 million shillings.
You want it done because there is a purpose for which you want the job to be done. And we will be more concerned if actually the days are on his part and you find that those days are resulting into more costs for you. You have to be careful on that.
Report by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.